Hi, welcome back to the channel.
And welcome back to part 6 in this epic series of rebuilding a Nissan
Pulsar
GTiR.
In today's episode, what we're actually going to be doing is slightly less than what we expected in the first place. We mentioned in the last episode that...
Linked above,
yeah. That we were going to be doing some belts, and it was going to be a little epic journey within this epic journey. We've had a look at it, and it doesn't look that difficult. So we'll bring you along for the journey, and hopefully it's a nice, easy one.
Right, so... we thought it was going to be hard because...
I'm sorry. It's the...
Why are you laughing?
We thought it was going to be hard. It's the first thing. Anyway, we thought it was going to be difficult because there's absolutely no room down here. So right here is one of the... actually the biggest engine mount. And almost directly below that is the bulkhead. And then flat against the bulkhead are the pulleys. So you'd expect absolutely no clearance, and therefore...
And didn't you hear some rumours as well that it was going to be quite hard?
I watched a, as well. I mean, I watched a YouTube video, which you should like and subscribe to our YouTube videos.
You should. You really
I watched
should.
A YouTube video where someone took the entire left-hand side of the car apart to get to it through the wheel arch.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, that... also jacking up the engine and taking the...
Yeah, because you were like, oh, we need to jack up the engine. I'm like, by what? You're like, the sump. I'm like, what?
Well, you can do it just with a wooden plank, but you shouldn't. I mean, not a plank, but, you know, a wooden block.
Yeah.
But... we were having a little bit of a mess around when we were doing the last lot of videos, just to see if we even stood a chance.
Yeah, so basically what we did, we finished, if you don't remember, in the last episode we did the valve cover gaskets, put the dress up bolts on and things like that.
Yeah.
And then afterwards, we just had a quick look, as we all do, in terms of like when we make videos and stuff like that, it's just to double check and see and plan the next video to make sure that we can actually do it, because obviously there's no point saying it and then we get to it and we're like, well, we'll
that'd be awkward.
Super awkward. That'd be some nonsense. And we had a look and it actually looked all right.
Yeah.
Because there's a lot of access.
Yeah.
Let's show them now, actually.
Yeah. Okay.
Right. So this is, again, transversely mounted.
Yep.
Engine. Epic engine. But yeah, so it looked to be really difficult because it's right up against here, essentially.
Yeah. And it looks like you need to get past the engine mount here, which you kind of do, but we're going to try and work around it by adjusting the alternator on the right-hand side and the power steering all the way over on the left-hand side, just down there. The difference between this engine and all the other SRs is that normally the power steering's on the right and the alternator's on the left.
Yep.
So all the belt diagrams that I've managed to find for the car don't match.
All the other side.
Yeah.
And then we were going to be looking at access. It's sort of down up and through here because you can actually see. And this is one of the belts that we sort of popped on just to have a look roughly to see what the access was like, wasn't
it? Yeah, see if we could do it before we even tried.
Again, just that kind of prepping for a video sort of thing. So
are we planning things now?
I know.
Is that a bit... that's worrying.
We're getting all right with this YouTube car nonsense.
You've bought accidentally 4 belts, which is kind of 2 kits of belts.
Well, because I didn't know, in true Nate fashion, I've got cars without aircon all the bloody time.
Yeah.
My Z has aircon, but it doesn't have aircon because it doesn't work.
It's broken, yep.
My truck has the weirdest aircon you'll see in your life. Part of it there. And it does actually work.
That's the intercooler, isn't it?
Yeah, so that's what someone thought. And then this Pulsar, I thought it might have it or might not, I just didn't know. It doesn't have it, from what we can tell. It has the provisions for it, but I think it's been removed.
Oh, that's a shame. I don't think it's got a button for it. It's hot and cold.
Does it not?
No, it just goes hot and cold.
I think the cold, is the cold not the aircon part?
No, cold is just cold.
Never mind. Well, anyway, so because I didn't know whether it actually had aircon or not, because I'm a plum, I bought all of these belts, and they're supposed to be a belt kit, but then it's not even the right ones anyway, is it?
Yeah,
some of them are not right.
Exactly. So we're just going to take everything, loosen everything up, have a go at fitting the belts, tension it all back up. Luckily, because this hasn't got a power steering, there's only 2 belts. One that goes from the alternator down to the crank pulley, and one that goes from the power steering, water pump, to the crank pulley as well. So
basically, one step closer to actually getting this thing running and you guys actually hearing it. So,
yep.
So what we're going to do now, we're just going to time lapse it.
Thank you.
Right, so, not a massive issue, but as we had issues with the slave cylinder, same kind of thing. They're just stuck, aren't they? The bolts are just stuck. It's the adjuster, basically. You saw us messing around with it for quite a while. It's the alternator adjuster.
Yeah, that's the alternator.
So we just soaked it in WD-40.
Yeah, just waiting for it. Then. We actually did find that some of the alternator bolts are already loose.
They're quite loose, actually.
Yeah, so it's already ready to be adjusted. It's just the adjuster stuck. That might be why they gave up.
True.
Yeah, could just be.
True. So just soaking it for now. We're just going to let that obviously seep in, do its thing, and then we're going to get back to it in a second. Hopefully, we'll be able to move it.
Stuff in your face. That's what happens when you're recording stuff for YouTube. You can't, no time for lunch.
Super professional.
So, reason we're in a car now, we were just having a mess around with the belts, as you hopefully have seen.
We got it. We nailed it. GoPro, it was there.
And managed to do it. So, the belts that Nate's bought, one, thankfully, after much trial and error, I've cut myself.
So. Only one. I did it with my hand as well.
Yep. So we're both.
Only one belt works.
We're bleeding for this car. So only one of the four belts work, and we figured out using the length of one of the other belts that isn't the right width but right length that we can go and pick up the right width belt right now. So we're on the way to go pick up the belt. Only downside that stuck adjuster bolt that we were talking about on the alternator.
Universal.
That's properly gone. We're going to have a go at really attacking it with the your driver.
Yes.
Your torque driver.
And yeah,
hopefully that'll fix it. If not, we might have to just cut it out and Nate's gonna have to order a new one. But
and what car are we in? That I haven't seen for ages.
370Z.
So this car.
Really close. Also, you don't really need to run the car, so even if we can't tension it up today, we're not going to run the car today because it's still got no fluids in it at all. But it means that we're really close. It's all the easy stuff now to just.
The finish line is just there.
And you've still got a clutch.
And we've got a clutch. So it means that we're one step closer. So we'll catch up with you guys when we've got the belt or when we're in the store anyway.
Yep.
Got a belt, finally.
Got the belt.
Quite quick, actually, not too bad.
No, well, luckily it's only around the corner.
Yes. So, same brand as before, better quality, apparently you think so. Why do you think it's better quality?
This is the exact type of belt that I put on the GTR, had put on the GTR.
All right, well, if it lasts on the GTR, I think it will last on a Pulsar GTiR.
Exactly.
The baby GTR. So, we're going to go back now and hopefully fit it.
Yep, we'll mess around a little bit with that bolt, and I had a quick Google while you were buying
adjuster.
The belt. Yep. Hopefully you can buy a replacement if we can't get it apart, but
fingers crossed.
I think we're going to do it.
Onwards!
Hey!
Right, so we're back. We're ready to go with the new belt.
But bad times have happened. With the bolt that we thought may snap as
Ugh. So we now have to take off the entire assembly part of it all, the sort of bracketry for it.
No, not that.
We do have to take off the bracket. We do, because you can't get the bolt out otherwise, can you?
Yeah. Now this is snapped off. This was the only bit that was actually holding it in. So when we take the single bolt out, the whole thing will fall out.
Yeah, that's true.
So this the bracket itself can stay. We're just going to have to pull out the rest of the thread and the little adapter plate. But, as I said before, don't need the alternator to run the car, it only needs to be there to charge the battery. So
We will probably not do much more in terms of getting the actual engine running until we have it, because we have quite a lot to do on this engine, and the battery will need to be charged for when we do all of that. So kind of a win, one belt's on.
I'd say the more difficult belt's on, and luckily the power steering, just about see it down this little gap here, power steering adjuster was nice and loose already, and that didn't cause any issues.
No, that one was all right, actually.
But I was just before we started recording this, I was mentioning that I think this is why they start to give up. Little bits like this where, we haven't got the belts fitted. Oh, well, the adjuster's not working. The clutch has stopped working all of a sudden.
That's true.
That's what brings you to the point where you're like, I can't be bothered with this project anymore.
Very, very true. Also, don't mind all of this crap. We're going to get rid of this in a minute. So sort of successful, but also sort of not.
Yeah. I'm still happy with the progress today.
I was literally just about to speak. I am as well, actually. The progress is pretty damn decent. And it's been pretty good, like pretty quick succession. So we've got the clutch to work. That's great. Yeah. We've got one belt on. That's great. We now know the size for the other belt because we had wrong belts anyway. Well, I had wrong belts because I'm an idiot. That's great. But now all we need to do is get a new...
A replacement one of these.
And the bracket part of it as well. The other bolt thing.
Yeah, the little... I think they come as one normally. So you found a kit.
I found one for like a Subaru Impreza or a Subaru Forester. I don't know whether it'll work, but might get it just in case because I can't find one just for Nissan. I don't know why, but never mind. It's all coming together now. I think
compared to the job that it was going to be.
Yeah. Oh yeah. God. We literally thought we'd have to take off, you know, the wing, like just like the wheel was going to be jacked up. It's going to stay on jack stands. It's going to be a nightmare. So it is much, much better. I think what are we doing next now on this?
I think the next thing that you were going to do was service it so that we get the fluid, well, at least the oil back in it because it has no oil.
Yeah, true. I think that's probably going to be a good idea. I think we'll service it next and only be a partial service. It'll just be an oil filter change, because then I can technically start it up to at least circulate the oil because it doesn't need to be circulated as well. And then I'll just switch it off immediately because...
Yeah, no coolant in it.
No.
So.
But yeah, it's going really well, I think, thus far.
I think we might be able to get a start video within the next week or so.
In the next week?
I think so.
Oh.
Oh, I mean, depending on how rainy it's been, it keeps raining, then not raining,
true.
Then raining.
Very true. So, sort of a negative end, but sort of not. It's hard not to feel demoralised when something like that snaps. That's what's annoying, I think.
It was so stuck, I was expecting it. You would have had it. Actually, it's better to have snapped, because at least we didn't have to get an angle grinder down there to cut it off.
You wouldn't be able to.
Exactly, that's what I'm saying.
Literally wouldn't be able to.
If it was stuck in there permanently, that would be, it's stuck there now. But at least it's snapped, and I can get it out easily, or we can get it out easily. So
if you're new here, please do hit subscribe, turn the bell notifications on. Definitely do hit subscribe, because there's 49% of you, or 50% of you, that are not subscribed. So please do hit that subscribe button. It helps us out quite a lot. Yep. Stay tuned for more, lots more on this, the Pulsar GTiR, on your
Nissan GTR, beast. Skyline,
absolute monster.
We do this every time.
Absolute monster. And then obviously my 370Z, which we do have a video on coming soon.
And that's another car nonsense.
Exactly. So thanks so much.
Love you.
Take care.